I used to be a simple businessman. Then one day, I came up with a simple idea. When I say simple, I don't mean I'm thick, otherwise I wouldn't follow this. The bang tidy fern thingamajig and Ollie Watsy captainising a celebrity panel show hosted by me, Keith Lemon. What is this programme? Celebrity Juice. Hello, I'm Keith Lemon and welcome to Celebrity Juice. Now, it's really hotting up with the X Factor. We've got the 12 finalists and we're getting to get used to their new faces. Even Danny Minogue's face, I don't know if you've seen. Have you seen her face? It's stiffer than I am when I introduce our two team captains. It's Holly Willoughby!
Hi!
Holly!
Yes, Keith.
Who's on your team?
Well, I have got TV's very own Dave Berry. And also absolutely stunningly gorgeous Gary Gates. Thank you, boys.
How's it going, Gareth?
Yeah, really good, mate.
Oh, it's gone.
What's gone?
Nothing.
What must stammer?
Yeah. Let's meet the equally bang tiny second team captain that is Dot Cotton. Who's on your team?
I'll tell you who's on my team. It's funny man and stand-up comic and Essex boy, Russell Kane. Not only that, what time is it? It's only Chico time.
Okay, the first round is the picture round. Just so it is called the picture round. Basically, what our teams have to do is have a look at a picture of a celebrity and link it with the picture below and tell me what the story is. So let's have a look at the pictures. The pictures are Robbie Williams, Richard and Judy, Pamela Anderson, and the objects are a cannabis leaf, an aeroplane, a birthday present, and an alien. Fern, it's your go first.
Is it maybe Robbie Williams? Is he smoking a lot of weed recently in an attempt to kill his short-term memory to forget all about Rude Box?
It's his birthday last week, so it could be that he's got a present. He got a new record deal from Gary Barlow.
Right, I do know this. Right, OK, so
Robbie
is very obsessed with aliens recently.
Yes, he is. Yeah.
He loves aliens.
Yeah, that's correct.
Yes.
It's just split from his girlfriend, yeah?
Yeah, because...
Do you know what the paper said was the reason why...
Yeah, because he loves aliens. He's all obsessed with aliens.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's correct, yeah. But what has Robbie recently been seen wearing? Answer that
one,
then.
No, I've seen a picture of this in a magazine. He was dressed as a gorilla, sort of very subtly blending in Hollywood, not drawing attention to himself dressed as a gorilla.
That's correct. It cost $60. It bought it from a fancy dress shop. I think we've got a picture. There he is. Is it a gorilla or is it a ginger teen wolf?
And he's...
That is a man having a breakdown, isn't it?
It's the glasses.
Getting into aliens and dressing up as a gorilla. He's on a breakdown, isn't he? I'm not surprised his girlfriend dumped him. It's not the biggest sex appeal to get into Dungeons and freaking Dragons and start looking up aliens.
Fern, do you think he's really mad?
I think he's going for a little phase.
Like a kind of... Now I gotta cut loose. Do you want
to
sing a song?
Oh, no, please don't.
Go on, Chico.
Do you want to sing It's Chico Time?
Go on, Chico.
No, I sang Chico Time too many times.
Go on, sing it one more time. Do you want to ever sing Chico Time?
Yeah. Well, you can get delirious if you take life too serious. It's Chico Time.
Chico, first time I saw you on... I don't know if anyone agrees with this. Not in a bad way, because I'm a little bit camp myself.
But
I thought... The question did occur to me.
Was I bent?
Were you a bit on the gay side? And
was I...
Is he a pillar buyer?
The last time you asked me that, you said, are you bent? And I said, no, is your ass crooked?
I don't remember it. I was rehypnoled at the time.
It's like, it's Chico time, please. I just want to wake up.
You all right, Ali?
Yeah, I'm good. You?
Well, pick a celebrity then.
All right.
And below.
We're just
it's fucking ages.
So we've got Richard and Judy or we've got Pammy. I've got a feeling Richard and Judy, although this is kind of unexpected because I never thought to put them together with a cannabis leaf, but they did admit to smoking a little bit of dope back in their student days.
Right, that is correct.
Yeah. Yeah. Brilliant. I've never met Richard and Judy, so I don't know whether they've
got... I've got off my box with them.
Really?
No, I don't condone drugs. Just say no, no. Just say no, just say no, no.
Keith, I don't condone drugs either, but if I was going to get stung with anyone, you'd want it to be Richard and Judy. Going to their spliff club. This week, we're trying a Moroccan hashish.
I can't imagine them getting stoned.
Judy,
don't pass it to her.
You're shaking, love. Smoke some of this.
Don't, Ollie. You'll spoil your reputation of being also prim and very proper. Anyway, the last picture was Pamela Anderson, who this week went to Hugh Hefner's birthday party. It was his 82th birthday party. And she went dressed in absolutely nothing apart from ghost boobs covering her. Well, I think
she wore
these.
Yeah, they're all like blurry.
Well.
I saw that picture.
Actually, she wore these.
And that is like the worst
she wore
ever.
These only. And it's my birthday next week. So I'm just wondering, girls, if you could wear them. You wear them. You wear them. Don't wear the ghost boobs.
It's
though.
My birthday today.
Is it?
Why don't you put them on then, Chico?
Get them on! Yeah. Yeah, the scars at the end of that round are...
shitting!
Well, yeah, scary. Well, that was a fantastic round, wasn't it? It's a BT round, and basically, what they do, stop clapping, I'm talking! Look, see, Chico time, come here. Come here. This next round is called Caught on Camera, Keith. Chico time.
What we're doing?
Look what it spells. Come to the BT!
It seems to be in order. I've written a special song. For my true love, because we're getting back together. Hey, I'm feeling really blue, because that's the colour I go when I overdose on you. Hey, I've really got to have you back, now that you've dumped that Jamie Hinch twat. Thank you, mister. Thank you, mister. I've got some real class A's. I've got some Garibaldis. We're gonna get off at a box.
So there we see Pete Doherty, who is he's getting back with his girlfriend, hopefully. That's why he's done that little song and he's put it on YouTube and stuff. Kate Moss?
Yeah.
That's who he went out with. He's trying to get back off with her. So here's an observational question for Holly's team.
Okay.
What instrument is Pete playing in his hands?
It's the classical guitar.
That's correct, yes!
Well done, Gacy.
First team.
Yeah.
How much money was in the at?
That is a bit harder than the other question, isn't it? What instrument was Pete Doherty, who normally plays a guitar?
Yeah, but it was for Gareth Gates.
So I have a very bad speech impediment, so yeah, that had to be a very easy question.
Yeah. Yeah.
See you in the buzz around.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly, we're not joking.
Yeah. Was it about £3?
£3.
No, that's incorrect. It was £5.37.
Oh, that is a stupid question. Gareth, I hope you don't take offence to this, but I think you look like a slightly healthier, younger, good-looking version of Pete Doherty.
Gareth, you look like a crack addict.
No!
A drug-free Pete.
He does!
This is how Pete could have looked.
Chico, you know what?
Tell me.
I think you could be his dad.
I'm not that handsome, surely.
No, you are.
No, you're not.
Holly's team. Pete Doherty's first appearance on MTV was when he was 18, but does anyone know what he was doing at the time?
I actually know this.
Say it then!
Hey, I know it!
He was... Do you?
Yes.
Come on here, looking like a healthy crack addict. Taking my answer, stealing my thunder.
You're taking the glamour out.
Listen,
of crack.
I can speak now, let me speak.
Spotted!
No, he was in HMV queue for Oasis's album when he was 18 or something.
That's correct, right? I think we've got a clip.
Right.
Let's have a look at a VT.
I subscribe to the Umberto Eco view that Liam's a town crier and Noel's a poet, and that's always, for me, a perfect combination.
If there was one word to sum Oasis up, what would that word be?
Trousers.
you want to be a presenter?
Oh, God, a pretentious little bastard.
So don't you like Pete Doherty?
No, but I just think that's a jumped-up, pretentious 15-year-old twat.
They should get a point deducted for that point.
Yes. Fern, oh. Back off! Oh, my
Fern, your team are next. Why has Kate Moss been spotted in the British Museum this week?
Oh, yeah. Chico,
she's don't been immortalised. In a statue of herself, her legs behind her ear.
This is it! In gold.
In gold.
I can't take it seriously, because that's the position me and my brother used to do when we were lighting her farts. Just put her feet right up there and then go...
How flexible are you and your brother?
I went camping with Ollie Willoughbilly. And
This is good.
We were in a Winnebago, and she said, everyone can use the toilet, but don't do solids. So she got in there, and she produced a solid. SPAT! She's got the face of an angel, but the arsehole of a tramp. Chico time.
Hello, sir.
This is my show. I fund it and everything. And I just because the lads and that, do you want to see a bit of minge? Look for a bit of minge? Yeah, have a look at this. It's not really minge. It's a wolf boy's mouth. or is it Leslie Ash with pubes all over the face?
That's gone, it's live!
It's time for an ad break now, but this is what's coming up in part two.
Who's the most famous person you've ever tried to chat up?